God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. As we gather together this evening in vigil service for Judy, we bring before the Lord here our prayers, our grief, our sadness, our hurts. We also bring joy and good memories. So as we begin our vigil tonight, let us begin with our gathering song.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans.
Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life.
If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer
But the There's quite an incredible depth to Judy, and we would be certainly doing her a disservice to say that the depth of Judy was only wrapped in music, because she was so much more than that. And for Judy, as much as faith, as much as the music played an important role for her, what played an even greater role for her was her faith, all the way up to the end. Being able to spend some time in her final night at that hospital, singing songs, praying mysteries of the rosary, deep down we could see through what was happening and know that Judy was at peace. She was at comfort. This is how she would want to go. Surrounded by so many people, surrounded by so many of the things that she loved. Music of faith. Christ. Christ standing right there in the room. The one who is ready to welcome her with open arms. So as much as music played an important role, faith played an even greater role. This church community played an important role for Judy, with Judy. Her service with Catholic Daughters, her service to many, many, many Turkey dinners over the years, given again back. Judy's selfless spirit continues to live on, continues to gift us. And I think the third beautiful aspect that Judy lived out so incredibly well, certainly her great love of music, her great love of the faith, her great love of travel, being able to, especially towards the end of these last few months, these last few years, being able to get out, being able to see many places, many spaces, extremely important. But along the way, being able to connect with those that she's loved, those that she's cared about, or those that she's cared for. Judy has had an opportunity in the course of this life to visit many places, to travel to many spaces, live many adventures. More than anything, Judy saw this life as one big journey, one big adventure. While it certainly had her beginning a long time ago, this does not mark an end. This marks another transition, the start of another journey. We certainly like to think that Judy did the best that she could in this life. And now we pray that she enjoys the rewards of that eternal life, that as she makes one more journey, she makes her journey towards heaven, that she makes the best of that. Enjoys the laughter, seeing that big smile yet again, and even getting to play that heavenly organ maybe one more time. Judy has a journey to make, a journey to heaven. That's what she's lived her whole life for. Not for us, but for heaven. And in the end, that's why we gather together this evening and tomorrow, to pray for Judy's eternal reward, that as she joins with all the choirs of angels and all the saints and all of those who have gone before us, as they rejoice in their heavenly kingdom with their heavenly Father in the greatest choir ever assembled, may she get to sit down at that beautiful organ and play a song for them that rejoices in their reward. God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, we certainly gather in sadness at missing Judy, missing her gifts, missing her voice. confidence and faith in the power of his cross and resurrection. And our response is, Lord, have mercy. Risen Lord, pattern of our life forever, Lord, have mercy. Promise and image of what we shall be, Lord, have mercy. Son of God, came to destroy sin and death, Lord, have mercy. Word of God, delivered us from the fear of death, Lord, have mercy. Crucified, Lord, forsaken in death, raised in glory, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, gentle shepherd, who bring rest to our souls, give peace to Judy forever, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bless those who mourn and are in pain. Bless Judy's family and friends who gather around her today. Lord, have mercy. Bringing our own prayers, we gather in prayer with Christ himself as he taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief and to receive Judy into the arms of your mercy. You alone are the Holy One. You are mercy itself. By dying, you unlock the gates of life for those who believe in you. Forgive Judy her sins and grant her a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are those who have died.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And with your spirit. As our sister Judy died with the Lord, may she now live with him in glory.
reading from the book of wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They sing in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was not an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not be like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not receive those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Scriptures chosen, and the journeys she traveled,
and his travel on. Yes, throughout the life, Judy did a lot of traveling, clicking off many bucket list locations like Mexico, Hawaii, Great Britain, Argentina, and many more. But the travels we will look at now are the journey of life of faith that you went through, the journey of a life of friendship, and the journey to eternal life. Her journey of faith started right here in Vanity. Well, not right here, but when she was born, if you didn't know, the church worship space was on the third floor of what is of the school. That's where she was baptized. I also mentioned that she received all her sacraments, married, baptism, first communion, reconciliation, confirmation, marriage, and now praying for her eternal salvation in this Christian Mass of their life. In baptism, Judy was washed clean from original sin and filled with the grace of God. Those gifts were further endowed in her confirmation. And she recognized that the gift came from God in the first place, and that to share these gifts with the church, the body of Christ, was part of her baptismal call. And share them she did. For almost 70 years, she used her musical gifts to write the worship in masses, made weddings truly a celebration with the Lord, helped mourners say goodbye to their loved ones, and made so many community events in the Fargo Market a time for joy, fun, and dancing. The gifts she received were further more than just musical. She received and shared those gifts with the church. She was a leader and organizer in so many areas. Helped form the Charitable Concerns Committee, helping the poor in our community, headed up the bazaar for many years, which brought the parish community together, was the service of the Catholic Daughters, the leadership on the Pastoral Council, stewardship and liturgy committees. These were all done not only out of a desire to volunteer, but out of the desire to serve the church and to serve Christ. The journey of faith was not always easy. It took work and sacrifice. It also cast times of hardship and testing, especially when her son Peter died. We heard in our first reading from the Book of Wisdom, as gold in the furnace he grew up. Gold ore has lots of impurities in it, so that to get the pure gold, it is put through a hot fire and the gold melts out, leaving the impurities behind. Times of great trial in our life of faith are like that. We suffer pain, hardship, the purification, and come out with the faith that is even more pure. And this is so true for Judas' experience of mourning in his life. A journey of faith. Judy tracks the highs and lows of that journey. A journey of friendship. If you didn't know, Judy was actually an introvert. Introverts may find larger groups, meeting new people, uncomfortable. But introverts also, when they enter into friendship with someone, they are very dedicated and loyal to that friendship. For Judy, that was a consistent truth throughout her life. Started with friends that you made in your neighborhood growing up, continued
friends in high school and college, especially through her sorority. She traveled with friends. They stayed friends even after the divorce. You know, it's kind of tough to travel with someone. And she made friends when she took her winter break with her brother in Arizona. In the sixth chapter of the book of Sirach, he talks about the qualities of a good friend. Judy, in her journey of friendship, lived out those qualities of friendship, relationship. The final journey I will talk about is the journey to life eternal with God. Our scriptures today speak of this journey. From St. Paul's letter to the letter of Romans, which was one of the oldest writings of the New Testament, he was speaking to a concern that the early Christians had. They were expecting the second coming of Christ to be very soon, even within their lifetime. It hadn't happened yet. So they were wondering about those people who had died before the second coming of Christ. St. Paul assures them that the faithful who have fallen asleep will rise at the command of the voice of the Lord when he comes to you. And then the gospel reading. This is from the final discourse, the final teaching that Jesus gives his disciples after the Last Supper and before he is arrested. He says, "In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself." In faith, Judy knew that God had prepared a place for her. She is now on that journey to the heavenly kingdom. We pray in this Mass and in the future that her soul will be purified in preparation for that eternal home. And then, when she completes this journey, that her intercession may guide us to join her, our friend, in the glory of God. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers today.
In baptism, truly receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness down and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sister Judy was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home in your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many people died by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Family and friends of Judy seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness of doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and
pray for our sister Judy. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, give her peace and healer of souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Invite you to be seated as we prepare our altar.
Jesus, you are.
Pray for me, sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept sacrifice and your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his sins.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Judy, we beseech your mercy, that she, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as with all men we acclaim.
The mystery of faith. Look with prayer upon the oblation of your church.
recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, Victor, our Bishop Emeritus, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Blessed gracious Lady, the prayers of this family who may have some of you. In your compassion and mercy, Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Judy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth we will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing of this life, give kind remembrance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when we will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be lightened for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who call and suffer in the Lamb.
Lord,
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister can be made comfort to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Immediately after our final combination, we'll go off into the gathering place and then go directly into the lunch line. One thing, if you are feeling any fever, feeling feverish, chills, loose mouth, shortness of breath, and loose sore throat, you must wait, you hit it, or you want a loss of sense, a smell or taste, invite your business to suit yourself and not join in the lunch. You might have seen an article in the forum today. There was a funeral in our diocese where people kind of set aside the mass at lunchtime in that burial, and they would huff and so on and so forth, hot and close, and many of them contract COVID. So we invite you to keep your mask on, keep social distance. If you want to, we also said you can grab your lunch and just go if you want to do that too. But protect yourselves and protect others here. So when you go out, we invite Kathy Goddard, who knew the honorary guard, and then the man following with the cremains, and then let's excuse from the transit first, and then from the front to the back. There is a line against the windows for the lunch line, and again, keep social distance between the cabins. Trusting in God, we have prayed together in unity, and now we come to the last prayer. There is sadness and pardon, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see duty again and enjoy the friendship. Although we disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Peace. Let's take our sister.